So I guess my next question to you, so we discussed Sweet Leaf and we discussed now Snowblind. How would you both compare and contrast the two, and which would you say you ultimately prefer?
I mean, that's such a hard comparison to make, honestly. They're both so good.
Obviously, the connection being that the two are the two drug center songs on that they've done.
Yeah, I think, from a sonic point of view, I think this song is produced better. I think there's more, like, ultimately more going on in this song that makes it more of an interesting listen. In terms of lyrics, I guess not being an avid cocaine user, but being an appreciator of marijuana, I guess I kind of, I appreciate Sweet Leaf in that way, in that regard. Mm-hmm. And just the lyrics in that one are more like kind of carefree and more like, come on, man. Like, I don't even know how to put it in words. You get basically what the song's saying. This song, yeah. On the other hand, is like, with that middle bridge part aside, of the angry bridge aside, there's some really beautiful imagery in Snowblind, I think. And just the analogs that they're making to cold weather, to blizzards, and to icicles and things of that nature are really nice. And if you just look at those lyrics, like, with the cocaine analogy aside, they're really beautiful lyrics, and they really evoke a lot of imagery that I think is just really well written. So this one's, like, the more well-crafted and honed-in version of their drug song, and I appreciate it for that regard. But I think Sweet Leaf is the more, like, raw, like, oh, let's just get stoned and, like, rock out kind of vibe. It's a lot more, like, laid back, I guess. This one's taking itself a little more seriously.
Yeah. That makes a lot of sense. I agree with all that. I would say, for me personally, I think I may have said this when we did our Sweet Leaf video. I think Snowblind is the more elegant song, in that I think the lyrics are definitely better. Like, I think it's better written and more well written in Snowblind than Sweet Leaf. I mean, I love the lyrics of Sweet Leaf and I love the feel of Sweet Leaf. Snowblind, I think, is just more well written. As I kind of made the comparison in this video, it feels like poetry.
Absolutely.
And everything you're saying with, like, sort of the analogy to ice and blizzards and will my ice age ever come, and, like, that whole sort of that line that they draw all the way through with snow, I think it's just so well done. I think in terms of, like, the main riffs, because obviously you got the main riff of Sweet Leaf and you got the main riff of Snowblind, I think the main riff of Sweet Leaf has more power. But I think the main riff of Snowblind kind of fits the song better. I don't know if that makes sense, but I feel like the overall craft and tone of Snowblind, I think, works better than Sweet Leaf. Although I love Sweet Leaf, I love the main riff, I love the solo in the middle, I love all the lyrics. It just feels to me like Snowblind, they may have sat down a little bit longer and crafted that a little bit more than they did Sweet Leaf.
Absolutely.
And part of that, I think, may be that they were originally planning on Snowblind being the name of the album. So that was going to be the song that was going to be the main focus of the entire album. And probably their constant consumption and love of cocaine made them take it just a little bit more seriously. And they put a little bit more effort into it. But also just, you know, they've had more experience by the time that they get to Volume 4. They've had, they have Master of Reality behind them, so they understand a little bit more about putting together an album and structure and flow, and so it just works a little bit more for Snowblind. I love both songs. I love them both. I think I would have to slightly take Snowblind over Sweetleaf, but that's just me. I absolutely love Sweetleaf as well, though.
Yeah. I think I like them for different reasons, so it's kind of hard to pick one over the other. But, I guess objectively speaking, I think this is just, like, a better song.
Yeah, I completely agree. And I think, in retrospect, I think it's interesting that out of all their songs, they really only have two drug songs. Drugs were such a big part of their lives for the 8 years that they were together. I guess you could make the case Hand to Doom is about, like, heroin and drug use, but it's not in the same, I guess, pun intended, vein as Sweetleaf and Snowblind, because Sweetleaf and Snowblind are all about, like how much they love these drugs and just how great it is. And it's sort of like both are love songs to the drugs that they love, whereas Hand to Doom is more like a cautionary tale about the use of heroin. So I guess technically they have three, but I think it's interesting that for how much, drugs were a part of their lives, that there's only a few songs that are actually about that.
Yeah. Do you think there was any like pressure from the record companies to like not make too many songs about that?
Maybe. I don't know. That's a good point. Maybe, yeah. But I also feel like they also already did songs that were about that. And true. I'm sure there were other, I mean, I can't think of specifics off the top of my head, but I'm sure there were other artists around the same time also doing songs about drugs. So that may have been part of it. But also I feel like as Black Sabbath gets bigger as a band, once you get into, say, like the second half of their 8 years, they're more calling the shots. However, I guess to a point with Sabotage, while they were making Sabotage, they were in and out of all these legal dramas. So that's a very good point, that it may have been more pressure to not go in that direction. But also it may just be that their focus for what kinds of things they wanted to discuss change. Because you definitely see a very interesting, if you look at Sabbath Bloody Sabbath, there's definitely a lot of interesting things that they're discussing lyrically in that album. And you also see that once you move on through the rest of the albums. I think comparing and contrasting Sweetleaf and Snowblind is a very interesting place to go to. Both are great songs, and I think both have their merits individually. But I personally would just kind of go a little bit more towards Snowblind.
Yeah, they're definitely, like, the analog to each other of Master of Reality and to Volume 4. They share a lot of similarities. If I remember correctly, Sweetleaf has a very similar song structure to Snowblind, does it not?
Yeah, I would say, I'd say it's very much along the same lines, where you have that kind of the main riff carrying all the way through, and then you have the explosive middle part, and then kind of goes back to that original. Yeah, they kind of share similar lines.
Yeah, and just that makes them two very good songs to compare to one another for a multitude of reasons. But yeah, no, they're both fantastic songs.